Hi guys, Nikhil here from Immortals India, and with me is Saransh Jain. Hi Saransh.
Hi.
So you've just played your games out at MESC FIFA, qualifiers.
Yeah.
Sorry. So what's your take on how the qualifiers have been so far? And in general, what is your perception on how the tournament has been?
So, like, I really like the event and the concept which you've come up with, because it's something different than what we see, not just for FIFA, but for CSGO as well. So I like that. My games went well somewhat. I've qualified for phase two. So hopefully I can make it to the grand final and do well there too.
Okay. So that being said, there's a different set of rules that we've planned out.
Yeah.
And Ankur has, you know, pitted everyone in a different way in Jaunty's yard. So what's your take on the challenges that have been put forth by Ankur?
So I think that's a different thing, because like usually or any tournament, that's not going to happen. This gives, like in FIFA or in football in general, you see that a better team losing, but they're having more shots or more possession, but not being lucky enough to score those chances. That's going to happen in FIFA as well. There are high chances of it happening. So in this scene, that other player who has higher possession with higher shots also gets the chance to play again in the phase two.
Okay. So an honest review from your end, where do you place the execution of MESC against the other organizers or other tournaments that you've played so far?
So this is my first tournament by Immortals. I couldn't make it to the FIFA one you'd done before. I think it's gone pretty well. Like I don't think I'll be able to compare it with others, because it's a different concept. Every tournament has its own uniqueness. But I think it's going well, and like hopefully I can do better, and the organization also does the same in the grand final or in phase two.
Yeah, that's good to hear. And getting on the little edgier bit, wherein you do not have the scalable opponents which we have seen in the past. I see a little variation from opponents that we have seen in previous tournaments, wherein we've seen the likes of Sid Chandrana, we've seen Sujay, we've seen Sudhin Dinesh travel for specific tournaments, and they have been good opponents to you. But unfortunately, they're not here today. And so I think that you've had the easier way out today.
I won't say easier way out, but comparatively, yeah, it's been easier, but like you never know, it's football, right? And obviously when I started out, I was a newcomer. I didn't race to the top. So we could find a new one here as well. So that's always there.
That's always there. That's a good point you noted out.
Yeah, so you can't underestimate anyone no matter what you think.
We've always known the humble Saransh Jain winning tournaments and winning trophies for India. But when it comes to a talking point wherein the competition is not that tough in this tournament, to be very specifically, yes, you have a bit of an ease here, but in the later stages of the tournament, you might face them. Is there a probability of you losing to them, or how is it going to go?
There's obviously a probability of that happening in every match, actually. It's always there in the back of my head. And actually, when you look at it from my point of view, when the competition is easier, there's actually more pressure on you. Because everyone's expecting you to win, and that's the tough part.
So yeah, so I was spectating one of your games. You had a scoreline of around 12-0 or something. So you did have a merry time, I would say. But the later stages might crush you as well.
Yeah, like they will, obviously, because the competition is only going to increase. And let's see how it goes.
Okay.
Okay, ask me it again, I'll try.
So any message that you'd like to say to your opponents, and you know, having a Christmas, you're a United fan, you know better.
Okay. I'll put some Mourinho.
Okay.
Put in your way,
I know.
Way, but it has to come out like, you know, you are putting out a challenge to others.
So now that
I'm going to ask this to everyone.
Now that we've spoken
all
of these guys, topics.
Everyone will be talking to you, there must be a long way. So I don't want you to fall behind in that. So I have a clear message, but obviously not right. That's what I have a strong thing about.
Okay.
So
Give me 2 minutes. Let me think. Okay, I'll say something.
So, just as we spoke of some of the major stakeholders in the FIFA community, like Sudin and Sujay, who've also represented our country internationally, like you have.
Yeah.
So, what have you to say on, you know, probably them facing you as opponents in the near future?
So, we've played in the past. I've played Sujay, I've played Sudin. They're obviously good, but you know, like how the game changes every year, and they used to play around FIFA 16, FIFA 17, right? So the game has changed a lot since then, and also the interest of the players has dropped a lot. And one thing which I have noticed since I've come into the esports scene is that there's a problem of consistency, which almost everyone has faced, including me. But since the 2 years that I've been playing, I've been, I would say, at the top since 2 years. And I mean, it's only going to get better.
So, do you intend to be on top? Yes, you obviously would. But do you think that there are potential contenders who could actually dethrone you? And do you see someone as a threat? And if yes, then who?
I see Charanjot as a threat. He's also a young kid, just like me, from Chandigarh. He's been, like, our games have always been 50-50, and it's a lot of fun to play him. So I'd say that in India, he's my best rival, or the one who threatens me the most.
And do you look up to anyone in the international fraternity, that someone who you would want to beat in the current meta? And you know, he's kind of a nemesis to you, but you can also see him as a guru. It's a difficult one to answer, but yeah, I would want to know.
No, personally, I don't look up to any single person. I obviously think that the people who are playing at the top are good, and I want to beat them. But my main aim is just winning. I don't care whom I beat. It's just winning.
Okay, that's fair enough.
Yeah.
So, internationally, we know that you are one of the prominent faces, and we would actually want you to dominate on the national scenario, to be that dominant on the international scenario as well.
Yeah.
So, to avoid any losses, do you have any set patterns, or do you follow some superstitious things, or do you have some cliches?
Yeah, I do. That's personally because of my mom, and also because of me. I always carry my own controller. I don't trust the event controllers. I carry my own USB cable, my earphones, everything. And I always carry a yellow napkin in my bag.
Yellow napkin.
A yellow napkin, yeah. I don't use it, I just carry it with me.
So like every top sports person in the country, you also are pretty superstitious, I would say.
Not pretty superstitious, but yeah, I am.
A yellow napkin in an esports player's kit is pretty superstitious.
Okay, I'll give you that one.
So, let's just take an overall view of what you feel is coming forward for the Indian esports community at large.
So, I'd like to speak about the offline events. A lot of people perform well online but are unable to do it offline. The gameplay is just the same, but it's only the thing that matches is the composure and the pressure that's put on to you. When you're playing in an offline tournament, there are people watching. The opponent's right next to you. Any movements you make, he can see them. So, that's one tough part. And let's see, man. Personally, since I've started playing, the number of events haven't been that much this year. With FIFA 20 coming out, this is the first event in around 2 months. So that's good. That's a positive. But it's also somewhat, I don't like how the people approach these esports events, because the main thing they consider is the prize pool, which is obviously an important factor. I won't deny that. I personally think so too. But you also need to support the community. You can't just sit at home and blame the events not happening when you're not turning up for any of them.
So you are amongst those lots who want people to come out on LAN, have that exposure, but also would want the organizers to give a look into the prize pool aspect also for FIFA. Am I right?
Yeah, because FIFA is a solo game, and like CSGO or Dota, they have huge prize pools, but when you look at it and you, when you split it among five players, it's almost the same as FIFA. Or maybe like in some cases, FIFA is higher. I don't know, like the players, they don't personally turn up that much, and that's going to be a big problem. So if you turn up, the organizers will see that the players are coming, so they're going to hold more events. And that in general will be beneficial for the community.
That is one of the things which we both, Ankur and I, both agree to, that during the previous event that we executed, we had a huge turnout. We had to literally execute the event on around, say, 10 to 12 consoles on the trot for a long duration.
Yeah.
So that was a kind of a thing which you missed out on previously. Wherein,
I was in Singapore.
Yeah, I know, I remember. And you were representing the country,
yeah,
I believe.
Yeah.
So at that point of time, those were different emotions which came out, because the hot favorites lost during the semi-finals and finals. And it would have been a great pleasure to have you there, actually. But unfortunately, you missed out on it.
Yeah, like the event was really good. I saw it on Facebook and everywhere. But I mean, it's also the area, the time, and all that affects it also. So you can't expect the same to happen every time. But like, this event has just started. You have phase two. You have so much more coming up. And the turnout for CSGO has been amazing. And I promise you, it will be the same for FIFA in the future weeks as well.
Well, on that note, thank you, Saransh.
Yeah.
And hope you just do well in the coming phases.
Okay. Thank you so much. Pleasure to be here.
Thank you.